न्यू एप्पल मैकबुक प्रो इज फेसिंग अनदर ऑकवर्ड प्रॉब्लम एंड आई विल बी शेयरिंग द डिटेल्स राइट आफ्टर दिस। व्हाट्सअप गाइज, वेलकम टू माई चैनल। आई एम बैक विद अनदर न्यू वीडियो। बिफोर आई स्टार्ट द वीडियो, बी श्योर टू लाइक इट इफ यू आर ए फैन ऑफ द एप्पल प्रोडक्ट्स एंड लेट मी नो डाउन इन द कॉमेंट्स वट डिवाइस यू आर वॉचिंग दिस वीडियो ऑन। The new Apple Silicon Macs are taking a lead in benchmarks and performance thanks to the new ARM-based M1 processor, but Apple's next generation of hardware is not bulletproof, as some owners are finding out. Following on from reports of the new Macs breaking themselves when attempting to restart back to a clean install, issues around Bluetooth are being reported. In this photo illustration, the new MacBook Pro seen on a mobile phone screen picked up by the respective Reddit communities, some users who have purchased the new hardware, the updated MacBook Pro, MacBook Air or Mac Mini machines are experiencing ongoing Bluetooth connectivity issues. One user said, "However, anytime I reboot the machine, I can't log in because the keyboard and mouse are not connected. Using the wired keyboard lets me log in and then the Bluetooth keyboard and mouse start working again." Another one said, "Losing connection to Apple Magic Trackpad 2 more than 10 times per hour. Also problems with the Magic Keyboard. That's not funny. I changed to an old Apple keyboard and mouse through USB." This would not be the first update to a Mac that has caused issues with Bluetooth. No doubt, Apple will, as always, be keeping a close eye on crash reports and user feedback. With the first update to Big Sur currently in public beta, the expectation is that the Bluetooth issue will be addressed in the bump up to Mac OS 11.1. While on the other hand, new Galaxy Watch 3 received update in Europe only. The Galaxy Watch 3 in Europe is now getting the same firmware update that was released by Samsung in South Korea a couple of weeks ago. Carrying firmware specific number, the latest update adds voice guidance in a couple of scenarios, such as when exercising with the smartwatch while having a wireless headset connected. Voice guidance is now always provided for travel distance and HR data when the Auto Lab feature is enabled. But perhaps more importantly, the Galaxy Watch 3 update improved the system's overall stability and reliability, all the while improving blood oxygen measurement, which is one of the Galaxy Watch 3's main features and selling points. The update at hand debuted in South Korea earlier this month and it is now rolling out in Europe. But of course, if you have not received that firmware version in your region yet, then sit tight, as Samsung should be expanding the update's availability to more markets soon. And if you don't own the Galaxy Watch 3 but you are considering buying it, then this might be the perfect time to do so, not only because the user experience has been improved with the latest update, but also due to the fact that Black Friday is upon us and you are bound to find some attractive deals somewhere. The Galaxy Watch 3 now benefits from a hefty discount in the USA, while in European countries such as Netherlands, you can now buy it for the starting price of 299 euros. So what do you guys think about this video? Would you be interested in buying a Galaxy Watch 3 this Friday? Leave a comment down. If you have enjoyed the video, then a like would be cherished. Thank you.